Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your interest in this lecture. What kind of digital society do we want to live in? What our world looks like simply depends on our way of reasoning. It is our way of reasoning, it is our different paradigms that shape and form our world. At the beginning of this project, the question was to what extent the current pandemic is accelerating digital transformation. We now know that the current pandemic is capable of accelerating digital transformation, but this acceleration is no guarantee for a distinct, sustainable and innovative future development. We used fuzzy cognitive maps to model three possible future scenarios. It is interesting to note that the current COVID-19 scenario is very similar to the traditional growth-oriented scenario. But there are significant differences between an innovative sustainable scenario and the current growth-oriented scenario. Most interestingly, the three scenarios essentially differ only in their initial state vectors. So our way of thinking determines what our world looks like. But we have discovered much more. We now know that research and development plays a central role in all three scenarios. We now can see the relations between a sustainable development and digitization speed. A deceleration, a slowdown of digitization speed combined with an increase of product and process quality only characterizes the sustainable scenario. Other important key factors are digital literacy, mobility, and the degree of automation. Increasing digital literacy leads to more responsible social action and social compatibility. So it remains our decision in which world we want to live. Will it be possible to maintain the current growth-driven development in the future and possibly accelerate it even further? Does that make sense? Or don't we all want to live in a sustainable, livable and socially compatible world? What will a sustainable smart city of the future look like? We don't need complex solutions for this. We need simple and widely accepted solutions. Smart digital transformation needs a sustainable, real environment. Electric cars, e-scooters and smart digital traffic controls won't solve our mobility problem. No software will save the world. We don't have a traffic problem. Our problem is a city structure that is exclusively dominated by individual mobility. It is the unbridled distribution of urban functions that generates mass traffic. It is also our habitual, our everyday behaviors. It is our all individual lifestyle that fosters this development. But these things can also be changed for the better. Imagine you're able to meet most of your needs within a short walk or a bicycle ride from your home. This would be possible with an intelligent and targeted distribution of urban infrastructure. There are even long-standing and viable urban models for this. The 15-minute city and rezoning are interesting role models for sustainable urban development. These ideas go back to other interesting city models, as we will see later on. So now back to our project. This paper presents one of the first applications of fuzzy cognitive maps in the context of digital transformation. Fuzzy cognitive maps consist of components and weighted relations. They fall under the so-called soft computing methods in which fuzzy empiricism is combined with computer-aided simulation. Components and correlations can be collected via literature review, an expert survey, or using other empirical methods, such as the Delphi method. With suitable software, fuzzy cognitive maps are then created. This makes the model operable and able to represent different scenarios. Soft computing methods are often applied in political and social sciences, but also in life sciences, computer science, economics and engineering. The aim of this project was a proof of concept whether this method can be applied to digital transformation in architecture and urban planning. It was not a declared goal to extensively collect data. A literature review was performed with 14 studies on digital transformation in architecture and urban planning, 12 studies in computer science, philosophy of science and media ethics. While reading the literature, many terms were used ambiguously, often with different meanings, unclear and in different contexts. In the end, we were able to identify four groups of stakeholders and related concepts: politics, research and development, economy and civil society. There are six drivers in digital transformation: the four thought styles or ways of reasoning in politics, research, society and economy, the size of the population, and the affordability of digital technologies. Moreover, we identified five indicators of digital transformation: primary energy consumption, degree of automation, digitization speed, the total number of digital processes and technologies, and the share of sustainable digital processes and technologies. On this basis, we now were able to build an abstract model including three alternative scenarios. First, a traditional growth-driven scenario; second, a COVID-19 scenario; and third, an innovative and sustainable COVID-19 scenario. Here you can see a graphical representation of the traditional growth-driven scenario. You can see the groups of concepts according to the stakeholders. On the left upper hand, the nodes of politics; on the left lower hand, the nodes of civil society; on the right upper hand, the nodes of research and development; below, the nodes of economy. At the lower center, you can see the five indicators of digital transformation. This is the graphical representation of the COVID-19 scenario. You might have recognized that this scenario looks very similar to the first scenario. To make all three models comparable to each other, they have the same number of components and connections, so they all have the same general structure. They all have the same density and the same number of connections per component. All three scenarios have exactly the same complexity score and the same driver components. To receive three different scenarios, only the initial state vectors and the individual weights of the connections are changed. Deviating results and behaviors could therefore be identified more easily and clearer. At last, this is the graphical representation of the third scenario, the innovative and sustainable COVID-19 scenario. You might have recognized the changes in the individual weights of some connections. In the next three slides, you will see the results of the three different scenarios. When you look at the indicators, particularly at the indicator of primary energy consumption, you will see that the COVID-19 scenario has similar values such as in the growth-driven scenario. But when we change slides to the third, innovative and sustainable COVID-19 scenario, you will recognize significant differences. The amazing thing is that all three scenarios only differ in their initial state vectors and individual weights of the connections. This means that the current pandemic is capable of accelerating digital transformation to some degree, but the pandemic is no guarantee for a distinct, sustainable and innovative future development. In times of COVID-19, sustainability is not necessarily written in capital letters. So our model shows that our way of thinking determines what our world looks like. Only with a slight change of the initial vectors and weights, an innovative and sustainable turnaround is possible. It becomes particularly interesting when we take a closer look at the parameter of centrality. Due to centrality, we are able to rank all concepts in all three scenarios. Future-oriented research and development play a central role in all three scenarios. We can also observe a decrease, a slowdown of digitization speed, combined with an increase of product and process quality towards the innovative and sustainable scenario. The improvement of product and process quality will lead to more sustainable and digital technologies. Digital literacy has a higher centrality in the COVID-19 scenario and a slightly lower centrality in the innovative and sustainable scenario, but it does not show up in the first ranks of the growth-driven scenario at all. So, what kind of digital society do we want to live in? In digital transformation, we are facing a radical environmental and social change throughout knowledge, digital literacy and technology. The Smart City Charter of the German Federal Ministry for the Environment identifies the following goals of digital transformation. Create data transparency, optimize processes, and increase resilience. The focus lies on participatory solutions in innovation processes and socio-ecological restructuring of the economy. The new Leipzig Charter calls for the just city, the green city, and the productive city. It emphasizes social compatibility, sustainability, and the digital transformation in urban space. Our model shows that fuzzy cognitive maps are able to operably map digital transformation in architecture and urban planning. Research and development will play a central role in all three scenarios. In a sustainable world, we all will see processes slowing down to a socially compatible and human level. Deceleration, a sustainable slowdown, is observable with an increase of product and process quality. Better products and processes lead to a sustainable digital transformation. The degree of automation of digital tools, therefore, can be a guiding assessment parameter. Our model has shown the importance of solidarity in social action. Our way of thinking determines what our world looks like. All stakeholders have to support the same idea at the same time. This means that sustainable change requires a unified and solidarity-based change in the way of reasoning on all sides. We all will have to review our current way of living. Currently, there are just a few standardized assessments of digital processes and technologies. Often, no clear distinction is made between conventional and sustainable digital technologies. Often, the mutual basics are missing. For sustainable development, we will need a reliable classification or an index for sustainable and non-sustainable digital technologies. This catalog of innovative and sustainable technologies could be used for targeted promotion and financing. Participatory solution in innovation processes will play a central role in the upcoming restructuring of the economy. Desirable would be a solid, worldwide, non-profit organization to make high-quality data openly accessible. For weather data, the World Meteorological Organization of the UN has been in existence for 70 years. Sustainable mobility, finally, is not only a question of the means of transport. Sustainable mobility is above all a question of sustainable urban structure planning. It won't be only the question of a new category of vehicles. What we need is a proper urban structure to avoid traffic from the beginning. Sustainable digital transformation can only exist within a real existing sustainable environment. How does a sustainable smart city of the future look like? With a smart and targeted distribution of the urban infrastructure, city models such as the 15-minute city become possible. In this context, we will also face the question of urban rezoning. The 15-minute city was initiated by Carlos Mourinho of Sorbonne University in Paris. His idea goes back to earlier city models such as Die gegliederte und aufgelockerte Stadt by Rainer, Göderitz and Hoffmann. These city models can offer practical solutions here. The current crisis is an opportunity for new ideas, for the meaningful restructuring of creative and productive processes. But this doesn't only mean investments in infrastructure and digital literacy. Finally, it is up to us in what kind of digital society we want to live in. Thank you for your interest and attention. For questions, I will be at your disposal right after the presentation.